Oh my freaking lord. Guys, I just watched episode 9 of Clone Wars Season 7, and guess what? The episode was amazing. Absolutely amazing. Damn, that's saying something. You guys ready for the episode review? As always, I will say what I think, the pros and cons, and ultimately, how I would rate it on a scale of 1 to 5. 1 being the worst and 5 being the best. Ready? Let's get started. What an incredible episode. The opening got me so hyped. It is different from anything we have gotten in Clone Wars history. We got a Lucasfilm logo in the beginning, which we have not seen for Clone Wars since the 2008 movie. There was also a part 1 screen with the episode name. No quotes anymore. Then the Clone Wars logo appears in the Star Wars iconic John Williams music. Not to be a critic to Kevin Kiner or anything, he also makes great soundtracks, but that mixed with so much of the John Williams music throughout the whole episode just makes it amazing. Going back to the intro, we get to see the episode 3 model of General Grievous. Yes! There is a scene of some Jedi discussing terms, and we get to see flipping Depa Balaba at young Caleb Doom, who will grow up to be my boy Kanan Jarrus from Star Wars Rebels. Then we get to see Plo Koon and Aayla Secura in their respective battles where they will die as a result of Order 66. Don't you get me now when I said I was so hyped? At this point, we already know we are tying heavily into Revenge of the Sith, and we are moments before the Battle of Coruscant. Based on what people are saying and the part 1 in the intro, this arc can be stitched together like a movie. This fits. Since Clone Wars started with a movie back in 2008, it is reasonable it ends with one. As for the episode portion itself, wow. Just wow. It opens to a battle on the planet of Yorbanna. People were saying we were going to get the Cato Nimodia business. Oh, you don't know what I'm talking about? Come on, you know. The one that doesn't count. It was sad we did not get to see that event specifically, but this being the opening of the episode or new Clone Wars movie was great nonetheless. It actually mirrors the original Clone Wars movie in a lot of ways. Obi-Wan and Cody were in a tough spot and Anakin came to save the day. The scene with R2 and Rex boasted me into laughter because when they interacted, I never expected the whole 501st Legion to be under that bridge. The other thing that mirrors the Clone Wars movie is that Ahsoka suddenly entered their lives. Anakin and Obi-Wan are called by Admiral Yularen to answer a transmission sent by Fulcrum. Have you guys noticed? Two Rebels references already! Anakin also mentioned Saw Gerrera, so I like they acknowledged his presence on Onderon. If you guys do not remember, when we got the hashtag Clone Wars Save trailer back in mid-2018, Rex called for Anakin and Ahsoka, not Admiral Yularen, so you guys can take the note of the change. Anakin's reaction to Ahsoka was priceless. I couldn't have written it better myself. This is starting to turn into a breakdown, and this video is supposed to be a review, so I'm gonna start picking up the pace. If you guys have not noticed, I can go on and on and on about this episode. It's that good. In general, there were just so many references to other Star Wars events. Bo-Katan mentions a teen, bringing Obi-Wan's feelings into the light. We got to see Ursa Wren again, and even Gar Saxon, another character we met in Star Wars Rebels. Then there was Almec. Oh boy, we had to run into him eventually. Then there was this other character, Rook Cass from the comics. Captain Rex being promoted to commander got me so happy. He deserved it. As for Anakin, we really got to see how much he cares for Ahsoka. To keep her lightsabers ever since she left the Jedi Order and to even trust her with a division of the 501st, the 332nd Company, that was insane. The farewell between the two was what I expected, but it's just so sad to know that this is the last time they see each other until their duel on Malachor 16 years later. Check out Twilight of the Apprentice and Star Wars Rebels if you haven't. The episode is actually pretty dope. Another thing to note is how much of a critic Ahsoka has become towards the Jedi. When Obi-Wan said he and Anakin needed to go see the Chancellor, she blurted out the Jedi were just getting involved with the politics and protecting the Chancellor, not people who really needed them most. Despite its criticism, I'm starting to see why the last arc, Ahsoka's walkabout, was so important. We got to know Rafa and Trace's criticism against the Jedi, and the inference in earlier seasons that there will be disappointing Jedi such as General Krell. Wow. Everything really is tying together for the finale. The fight scenes were excellent. Like I said before, them mixed with the John Williams soundtracks felt spectacular. Also, is it just me, or is the animation for this episode slightly better than that of the other episodes so far this season? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. The ending was sad, but we all know it will be worse later in the arc, if you know what I mean. Since Rex was promoted to commander, a clone trooper known as Vaughn took his place as captain. He and some other 332nd clone troopers follow Ahsoka into the sewers, but all the clones with her are killed by Maul's Mandalorian super commandos. The last line where Maul shows up was spectacular.
I was hoping for Kenobi. Why are you here?
It really goes to show how much hatred he has for Kenobi and his disappointment of Ahsoka's presence. This is actually the first time they have met in Star Wars history, the second being on Mandalore in Star Wars Rebels, Twilight of the Apprentice. I said it once, I will say it again. Watch it. Overall, this episode instantly deserves a 5. Definitely the best episode we have gotten so far this season. The cinematography and soundtracks were out of the ballpark, also taking into account the different scenes we got, and it was an episode that was longer than usual. 30 minutes with credits. That's pretty much all I have to say. Season 7, Episode 10 should be releasing next Friday, so stay tuned for its episode review then. Also, if any Clone Wars promo releases during the week, as always, I will react to it. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!